Hello students, in previous lecture we have discussed concept of decoder. IC7447 as decoder driver and with the combination of 7 segment display and 2 types of 7 segment display we have studied. They are common anode 7 segment display and common cathode 7 segment display. In today's lecture we are going to learn about necessity of multiplexing and demultiplexing and some problems related to multiplexer and decoder. So, as there are various applications of multiplexers and demultiplexer available, if the question arises like this, explain the need of multiplexer and demultiplexer, then you can explain in this way. As we can implement the logical equations by using mux and demux. In previous lectures, we have seen that concept of multiplexer and demultiplexer. By using that multiplexer and demultiplexer, we can implement by using logical terms and we can expand the multiplexers. So, by expanding that multiplexer or with the help of mean terms, we can construct any multiplexer. Due to that, the multiplexer, so cost and size of the circuit get reduced. And as multiplexer has many to one, means it has many input and only one output, it is used in many electrical circuit. Instead of using different types of ICs of basic gates. So, due to that, cost and size of the circuit gets reduced. Second, multiplexer and demultiplexer are also used in computer hardware to access memory for reading and writing. Third is, in telephone exchange, this is most important application. In telephone exchange, to select one subscriber and to connect it with another one which is very far away through telephone exchange. Means if suppose this here is a one subscriber, we have to connect another subscriber in between this exchange 1 and exchange 2 through this single telephone line. It is possible only due to multiplexer and demultiplexer. Let us see how it is possible. You can see here, suppose this is a exchange 1 and this is exchange 2. Suppose this is the multiplexer with 1, 2, 3 up to n inputs and only single output. And demultiplexer is exactly opposite to that of multiplexer. It has only one input and many output, like 1, 2, 3 up to m number of output. Mean any one input is selected and that is passed through this, and here out of many only one is selected and that is passed to the output of this multiplexer. Okay student, let us consider an example. If from out of this 1 to n subscribers, if we have to exchange information from this subscriber which are present in the form of n number of inputs to this m number of outputs, it is possible only this single telephone line present in between exchange 1 and exchange 2 of this two area of communications. Okay, for example, suppose we want to connect subscriber 2, okay, with subscriber 1. For example, if we want to connect subscriber 2 with subscriber 1 of this demultiplexer, then out of these n inputs, okay, out of this n inputs present in the exchange area 1. Okay, out of this n inputs present with this exchange area 1 that are passed through the output of this multiplexer, means only this 2 is selected and that is passed through the output, and that output will send on the connection of 1 of exchange 2, means one of the input is selected and that is given to the second exchange, one of the input is sent to the n output, means out of this n inputs only this number 2 subscriber is selected and that is sent through this exchange 2 input, and that is passed through the input, and the input is connected to the subscriber 1 of exchange 2 area. In this way, connection is used in between two subscribers, subscriber 2 to subscriber 1, and is connected with the help of this single line, that is single telephone line or single connection of line in between exchange area 1 and exchange area 2, that is in between this MUX and in between this MUX and DMUX. Is that clear, student? Now suppose in reverse order, if we have to connect user 2, okay, if we have to connect this user 1 to user 2, from this user 2, okay, now this user exchange area uses this multiplexer now instead of using this demultiplexer, and in the similar way exchange area 1 uses demultiplexer, because we have to select only one input out of this m input, okay, and that input is passed to the output, and that is given to the input of exchange area 1, and that is connected to the subscriber 1. Okay, student? So this 2 subscriber is selected out of this m number of input, and that is passed through the output of this multiplexer, not demultiplexer. So this multiplexer select out of this m only this subscriber number 2 and subscriber number 1 and pass to the input, and that input is given to the exchange area 1, that is nothing but demultiplexer, and that demultiplexer is nothing but 1 to many. It is exactly opposite to that of multiplexer. Multiplexer has many into 1 and demultiplexer has 1 to many, and it takes the input and select one of the output, that is exchange 1, sorry, subscriber 1. In this way, the information can be exchanged in between the subscriber 2 to 1 with the help of exchange area 2 and exchange area 1. In between that, both the areas, there is a single line. So, it is possible only with the help of multiplexers and demultiplexer. Okay, students? So, to select one subscriber and to connect it with another one, which is very far away through telephone exchange. Through telephone exchange, it is possible with the help of multiplexers and demultiplexer. This is most important application. And there are some important points related to this multiplexers and demultiplexer, as we have discussed these two topics in detail in previous video lectures. By using multiplexer IC, we can implement only one equation, but it does not require additional NAND gates. Means multiplexer can implement only one logical equation, but it does not require any other logic gate. Second important point about demultiplexer or decoder IC, by using demultiplexer or decoder IC, we can implement more than one equation, but it requires additional or NAND gates. Okay, students? So, remember this most important point. Question may be asked in the board exam. Explain the need of multiplexer and demultiplexer, or explain the necessity of multiplexing and demultiplexing. So, this much points are enough to write the answer of the question about 3 marks or 4 marks. Okay, students? So, remember all these points. Now, let us see why these 2 points are related to multiplexers and demultiplexer with the help of different examples. Now, this is a quite different example than the example we have discussed in the multiplexer topic with the help of mean terms given in the bracket. Okay, students? Instead of giving mean terms here, logical equation is given, and by using this logical equation, you have to implement the multiplexer circuit. Now, let us see how to solve. Implement the following equation by using suitable multiplexer. Y is equal to A dot B bar plus A dot B. Students, all of you know that how to construct logic circuit with the help of this given logical equation. This is a Boolean equation. A and B bar or A and B. Means to construct this logic circuit, it is necessary to draw if product is there and gate, if bar is there not gate, and for OR we have, for this plus symbol we have to use OR gate. Means if we have to implement this logical equation with the help of gates, it is necessary to draw 3 gates, AND gate, NOT gate, with the help of different ICs. For AND gate IC7408, for NOT gate IC7404 is necessary, for OR gate IC7432, all these TTL ICs are necessary to construct this logical equation. But we can construct this logical equation with the help of single block of this multiplexer. Let us see how to construct. First, you have to decide how many variables are given in the equation, and then you will get the number of select lines. As per the topic discussed in previous video lecture, before drawing the diagram, we have to find out number of select lines and number of data lines from the given equation or whatever the mean terms. Okay. As in given equation, 2 variables are present, which are that A and B. Okay. A and B are 2 variables. Therefore, as there are 2 number of variables, therefore 2 raised to 2 is equal to 4. Therefore, number of select lines are 2 raised to m is equal to n. Therefore, select lines m is equal to 2, and by relation n is equal to 4. Means we have to construct 4 raised to 1 multiplexer with the help of this equation. So, we have to construct the multiplexer which has 4 input and only 1 output. But here already this equation is given. So, by using this equation, we have to decide how many data lines are there in the given equation. As this is a given equation, Y is equal to A and B bar or A and B. First, you have to write the logical terms. Below each logical term, you have to write their equivalent binary digits. For A, you have to write 1. If B bar is there, so you have to write 0 digit. Here A is present, for A, logic 1. For B, here 1. And below each binary digits, you have to write their equivalent decimal data. So, this is 10 means 10 represent D2 data and 11 represent D3 data. So we have only these terms to connect to the positive VCC, and remaining terms, those terms are not given in the equation. We have to connect that both the terms to the ground level. Is that clear, students? So we have to connect data input D2 and D3 at high level, that is logic 1 or positive VCC. Remaining inputs are deactivated, means that they are absent here, by connecting to ground or logic low or 0. Now students, you can see this diagram of multiplexer. As we know that from this equation we have to construct 4:1 multiplexer. So 4 data inputs are here, but it is necessary to construct select lines. By using this 4 data input, it is necessary to construct 2 select lines, S1, S0. They are connected to data A and B. Then as shown in the circuit IC diagram, A and B are connected to the select lines S1, S0 respectively, D2 and D3. This is most important point, as only D2 and D3 are present according to this equation. D2 and D3 should be connected at logic 1 or positive VCC, whereas D0 and D1 are connected to the logic 0 or ground. Okay, and here this positive VCC and ground are provided for proper biasing of this IC. Then and then only this IC will work, otherwise it will not. Okay, and the most important thing beside all these terms, this is strobe input G bar, or this is called as an enable input. This strobe input G bar is always at the ground. Okay students, to activate or to enable the MUX IC. Is that clear? In this way, you can construct any logical equation given in the problem with the help of multiplexer. First you have to decide how many variables, then select lines, then data lines, then the given term should be connected at logic 1. Here only D2 and D3 are given in the equation, therefore we have to connect them to the positive VCC, and remaining term will be connected at the ground. Okay, so you have been connected these two terms D0, D1 to the ground, and D2, D3 are connected here, positive VCC. In this way, we can construct the multiplexer with 2 select lines and 4 data inputs. Now, let us see another example. As we have to implement the equation with the help of logic equation, in this equation, implement the following equation by using suitable multiplexer. But here are 3 variables present. You can see Q is equal to xy z bar plus x bar yz plus xyz plus x y bar z bar. Okay students, this is a given example. Now, like previous example, first we have to decide how many variables are present. As you can see, x, y, z are the 3 variables present in this given equation. As the given equation contains 3 variables, hence required select lines from this equation, 2:3 is equal to 8. Therefore, number of select lines are 3 and number of data lines are 8. So, we can construct 8:1 multiplexer. So, to construct this 8:1 multiplexer, these data lines are here, D0, D1, D2, D3, D4, D5, D6, D7. But out of these data lines, let us see how many terms are given in the equation. First, we have to write the given equation. Q is equal to x and y and z bar, or x bar and y and z, or एक्स बार एंड वाई सॉरी एक्स एंड वाई एंड जेड और एक्स एंड वाई बार एंड जेड बार. इन दिस वे यू कैन राइट द इक्वेशन. दिस इज गिवन इक्वेशन. सो हियर यू हैव टू राइट बाइनरी कोड बिलो ईच टर्म्स लाइक एक्स वन वाई वन. हियर जेड बार इज प्रेजेंट सो वी कैन राइट हियर जीरो. स्टूडेंट्स रिमेंबर दैट फॉर कॉम्प्लीमेंटेड वेरिएबल यू कैन राइट जीरो एंड फॉर रियल वेरिएबल यू हैव टू राइट ओनली वन. हियर एक्स बार मीन्स जीरो फॉर वाई वन फॉर जेड वन. इन द सिमिलर वे एक्स वाई जेड वन 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 एक्स वन वाई बार जीरो जेड बार जीरो. सो यू हैव टू राइट देयर इक्विवेलेंट डेसिमल डिजिट्स और डेसिमल डेटा. वन वन जीरो मीन्स वॉट. दिस इज डी सिक्स. जीरो वन वन दिस इज इक्वल टू डेसिमल थ्री. सो हियर इज डेटा डी थ्री प्रेजेंट इन केस ऑफ सेकेंड टर्म. फॉर थर्ड टर्म एक्स वाई जेड मीन्स दिस इज अ लास्ट टर्म दैट इज सेवन डेसिमल और सेवन डेटा इनपुट. देन एक्स वाई बार जेड बार वन जीरो जीरो. दिस वन जीरो जीरो गोज टू द फोर डेटा इनपुट. इन दिस वे बाय राइटिंग द टर्म्स देन देयर बाइनरी इक्विवेलेंट एंड बिलो ईच डिजिट्स यू कैन राइट द डेटा इन दिस फॉर्म. दस those terms are given in the equation that term should be connected at positive VCC or logic 1 and those terms are absent or deactivated they should be connected at the ground. Okay students, in this way we have to construct 8 as to 1 multiplexer. That multiplexer requires 3 select lines and 8 data inputs. Out of these 8 data input we can connect data input D3, D4, D7, D6 to the logic 1 or positive VCC. Okay, and remaining inputs are deactivated by connecting to ground or low. Okay students, so in this diagram you can see input XYZ are connected to the select lines S2, S1, S0. Then here D3, D4, D6, D7 are connected to logic 1 whereas D0, D1, D2, D5 are connected to logic 0. This positive VCC and ground connected for proper biasing of IC to work in the circuit. And the most important thing here, strobe input G bar, this is connected to the logic 0. Then and then this will active or this will enable the multiplexer. Okay students? So remember that these four terms should be connected at logic 1. See in this diagram D3, D4, D6, D7, 1, 2, 3, 4. These terms are connected to logic 1 or positive VCC. And those terms are not present here. That is D0, D1, D2, then D5 all are connected to the ground. Or 0 or logic 0. Okay students, and in this way this is the 8 as to 1 multiplexer which has these inputs and only one output. Okay students, so can you construct this circuit by using this equation? Yes, it is very simple. Now this is another one quite different example than the previous two examples. Realize the following truth table using suitable multiplexer or simply MUX. Okay students, and this is a given truth table. In previous examples there are different terms given in the form of logical equation, but instead of giving logical equation here truth table is given. So, by using this truth table, we can construct multiplexer. First, we have to observe this truth table carefully. This is not general truth table. Some terms are deactivated at the output. So by using this truth table, we have to find out the input which we have to connect at this logic 1 and which we have to connect to the logic 0. In this truth table, you can see if data input is 0, 0, 0, then multiplexer gives 0. Then 0, 0, 1, yes, here output Y is present. For 0, 1, 0, again there is output. 0, 1, 1, 0, means this is deactivated, this is also deactivated. What about this 1, 0, 1, this is activated output 1, and at last this is also activated. So how to find the terms for data input? Those outputs are high, only that output we have to connect to the logic 1. Let us find. In given truth table, 3 variables A, B, C. Therefore, number of select lines 2 raised to m is equal to n. Here 2 raised to 3 is equal to 8. Therefore, number of select lines are 3 and number of data inputs are 8. So, it is easily find out by using this equation. 8 are the data inputs and 3 are the select lines. But not all the data input gives the higher output. Some of them are deactivated. Okay. As per given truth table, to find input data lines are output Y is equal to 1. When for ABC 001, this is G1. For ABC 010 D2, this is the binary code and their equivalent decimal data input we can write here. 001 is equivalent to 1. 010 is equivalent to D2. For ABC 101, that is equivalent to D5, means this 4 plus 1, 5. And at last, ABC 111, therefore, this is D7. So, it is very clear that from the given 3 input ABC with the help of this truth table, we have to connect input D1, D2, D5, D7 to the logic 1 and remaining deactivated should be at the logic 0. So, input A, B and C are connected to the select lines. They are S2, S1, S0 in the similar way like previous examples. Then, D1, D2, D5 and D7 are connected to logic 1, that is positive VCC. Whereas D0, D3, D4, D6 are connected to the logic 0 or ground. Let us see. Already I have connected this input D1, D2, D5, D7 to the positive VCC. But remaining input will connect now here. Which input we have to connect? All the deactivated input. Which one are deactivated? By skipping D1, D2, D5, D7. So, here D0, then which one? Yes, D3, okay, then D4, make here dot, then D6. Okay, students? Means out of these 8 input, 4 already connected to the logic 1 and now I have drawn here remaining 4 deactivated input to logic 0 or ground. Okay, students? And positive VCC and ground are connected for biasing of multiplexer IC. At last, besides all these connections, all these terms, one most important thing that except this G bar, this MUX will not operate properly because this is called as a strobe input or enable input. When this strobe input is connected to the low input, then and then only this multiplexer will work, otherwise it will not. Okay, students? And at last, this is the output of this multiplexer. So, in this way, when the truth table is given in question, then we can implement this truth table in the form of multiplexer circuit, that is 8:1 multiplexer, by using these three variable. If there are four variables are present, then you have to construct 16:1, and that 16:1 multiplexer requires four select lines. So simple. So it has number of data input and this is only single output. So this is a circuit of multiplexer. Okay, students. We'll see in next lecture different type of examples on decoder. Okay, students. Thank you.